Understand she had some plumbing problems.
Oh.
May I take your drink order?
Yes, sir. This lovely lady's in the mood for champagne. A bottle of your best, please.
No problem.
Was that right?
Yes.
Good, then we're in sync.
So, what do you want to know about Lois?
Well, you don't beat around the bush, do you?
Well, I figure if you're springing $100 a bottle on champagne, I might as well satisfy your curiosity. Besides, you look like a man who likes to get his money's worth.
Direct and observant. Formidable combination in a woman.
Oh, in a woman? How about in a man?
Don't get your hackles up. I was born to a woman who's 50 years ahead of her time when it comes to the equality of sexes.
So what happened to you?
Now, you see, that's the trouble with the women's movement. You can't even compliment a woman on her brains and spirit without offending.
I don't offend easily.
I've noticed. Add a healthy ego to the list.
No, you're wrong.
So how well do you know Ned Ashton?
Ned is one of my best friends, which means that I will not sit back and let anyone do him dirt. You know, when Lois told you that they're meant to be together, she was right. They've gone through a lot to prove that. So what I'm really here to tell you is hands off.
Oh, poor, thanks.
Thanks.
Since I wasn't there for this proof, why don't you fill me in? Maybe it'll convince me.
I bet you're a shark at making deals. Okay, I will fill you in. Lois met Ned in Buffalo. She was managing a rock group. They were playing at a hotel, and Ned was at the hotel incognito, checking out the concert.
Lois
popped out of a cake at Catherine's birthday party and announced to everyone that she was the first Mrs. Ned Ashton.
I wish I'd been there. I would have carried her off into the sunset.
Oh, well, that would have been your only chance to do it. At that point, she didn't want to have anything to do with Ned. The only problem was, she was still Eddie May's manager. But you know, Ned never gave up on her. He did everything he could to get her back. And perseverance won out.
I figured as much. So she can be worn down with sincerity.
Jax, these two people have earned their happiness. And I will not let anyone do anything to wreck their marriage.
They're important to you.
Yes.
You're obviously important to them. More to the point, you're important to Lois. So I want to know everything there is to know about you.
Oh, God. Oh. Do you really think that that is going to happen over one bottle of champagne and a dinner?
Oh, no, I'm prepared to invest a sizable amount of time in this effort. How about caviar?
What do you plan on doing with this information?